I'm on my knees when I'm begging, 'cause I don't wanna lose you. Hey, yeah.
Who you gon' call when you ain't got the Me and Megan run up in the spot like I pop off 'cause I am the reigning champ. Please no comparisons 'cause you know they can't. Had to cut the grass, there was snakes in the camp. They know I'm the Billy, I be laughing. My guest house alone cost like 3 tickets in that Rolls truck.
Let me go, I'm on my knees when I'm begging, 'cause I don't wanna lose you. Hey, yeah. La, da, da, da. 'Cause I'm begging, begging you. Put your love in the hand now, baby.
We're gonna be off for you today.
And can I also have a small blue raspberry slushy?
A sausage McMuffin?
Ana shariatika ila nar, first class, direction Al Whale.
Will I be saved by the grace of Southern?
Que tu sois auprès de moi au paradis.
Muslim people are not all Allahu Akbar boom. Not like this. We are cute. We are Allahu Akbar, yes, like this. Not Allahu Akbar boom. Not like this, please.
When they haven't gotten their cap katab done yet, so Bob is their third wheeling.
People who have been single for too long are the hardest to love. They have become so used to being single, independent, and self-sufficient that it takes something extraordinary to convince them that they need you in their life.
Who needs friends when you have 11 siblings?
Did somebody break your heart? Looking like an angel, but you're savage, huh? And when you kiss me, I know you don't care enough. So take me up. Savage, did somebody break your heart? Looking like an angel, but you're savage, huh? And when you kiss me, I know you don't care enough. So take me up.
This is Ahmed, and Ahmed loves to tell girls to take their hijabs off because they're showing 1 inch of their hair. Ahmed loves to go smoking, partying, drinking, and all around just being himself. Don't be like Ahmed. Nobody knows if he's a Muslim anyway. No, seriously, guys, please don't be like Ahmed.
It's Shalichak.
Let's go get a wave. They say what they gonna say. Have a drink, clink, found a Bud Light. Bad bitches like me, it's hard to come by. The Patron, let's go get it down. The sound, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it 2, 3, leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't give a shit.
I'm on the floor, I love to dance. So give me more, till I can't stand. Get on the floor.
On the other side, and say.
you get your grills from?
I got them from Johnny Dang.
You lying?
Yeah.
ਅੱਡ ਤੈਥੋਂ ਜਰ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਹੋਣੀ ਬਿਨ ਪੀਤਿਆਂ ਟੱਲੀ ਕਰ ਜਾਣ ਹੁਸਨ ਤੇਰੇ ਤੋਂ ਨੇ ਹਾਰ ਕਰਨ ਨੂੰ ਫਿਰਦੇ ਨੇ ਕਾਰ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੱਲ ਤੂੰ ਟਾਲੀ ਜਾ
Bro pulled up in a Curda with a Topion
خرب شرفي اذا ابت بالعراق خرب شرفي
Damn, you fine as hell. Hey yo, think I can get you
now? Are you serious, my brother?
Let's go.
Squid war in the Middle East. Suhaila Chickabees. Patrick النجمة يلعن أبوك حفيز.
Will he perform when he has money right in front of him? Run up on that boy and kill his cousin right in front of him. I just tapped his shoulder so I know that he is...
That was cute! Wait, I can't even touch it.
Why? You can touch it. Open another one.
This is so cute, pretty.
But look at how pretty the dino was.
So my family's hometown in China is the Ningxia province, which is also known as the Hui Muslim Autonomous Region, and so I kind of just wanted to share a little bit about it. So Ningxia is home to China's largest group of Muslims, the Hui ethnic minority. It's located along the edge of the Gobi Desert, which was a major stop during the ancient Silk Road. So during the 7th century, when a lot of Arab and Persian merchants came through, some of them settled and intermarried. And so that's kind of how and where Islam was first introduced to China. The province is about 35% Muslim, and it is located in China's Quran Belt because the predominant religion in the entire northwestern region of China is Islam. And as for the food, I think this is kind of funny because in the West, they associate rice with Chinese food. But in northern China, they actually don't eat rice because it doesn't grow there. So these were kind of the Chinese foods that I grew up eating. They eat more like wheat and bready products. And these are some really famous dishes. Up there is lamb soup with Chinese pita bread sandwich, lamb skewers. So yeah, whenever I go back, there are halal food places on like every single street corner. Or in Chinese, the Mandarin equivalent is qingzhen. So Mandarin word of the day, qingzhen, means halal, but it can also be used to describe other aspects of Islam as well. The first character, qing, means clear, bright, clarity, and zhen means truth. So it means enlightened truth.
Assalamu alaikum, signs of aashiq jinn. Aashiq jinn is a jinni who's in love with you, and this always turns out in possession. You will get a lot of wet dreams. You will lose your hygiene. You'll take a shower and yet you'll still stink. Half an hour later after the shower, you will smell. Waking up with bruising on your body, unexplained bruising, or waking up with henna on your body. Fighting a lot with your spouse. Big fights out of small, tiny things. The jinni will go after your image. You might start losing hair, or your skin might get pale. You might start getting skinny. Or gain a lot of weight, you stop taking care of yourself, and the genie does that, of course, so nobody else can look at you and enjoy you or find any attraction in you. There are more signs to this. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to heal anybody who is suffering with this.
So earlier today, I went in to get a massage with a massage therapist who I've never seen before. When I got in, they had me sign, like, you know, the liability agreement contract, and they had me select whether or not I wanted my therapist to be wearing a mask while she gave me a massage. And so I asked, hey, is she vaccinated? They weren't able to disclose that. I totally understand why, for like HIPAA purposes. So I was like, I would prefer if she wore a face mask. The lady was like, all right, cool. I went into the massage room. The therapist came in. She was like, oh, do you have any problem areas? I told her, oh, cool. She leaves. I get undressed. I get on the massage table. She comes back in. She starts massaging me. And I'm noticing that she's only using her knuckles like the whole time. after about like 10 to 12 minutes of her massaging me only using her knuckles, I was like, hey, like, can you like use your thumb or like your fingers? And she was like, no, I can't. There's something wrong with my fingers. Like, I think she said she had like an injury or something. And I was like, oh, okay. And so then finally she says something and I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't hear you. What was that? And then she doesn't say anything. And then she mumbles something. So then I was like, I am so sorry. I can't hear you really well. Did you? And then she just goes off. She's like, I can't breathe with this face mask on. I am suffocating. And here you are, you're not wearing a mask and I have to wear a mask and I can't breathe. And why did you ask me to wear a mask? And I was like, I'm really uncomfortable right now. Cause she's like yelling at me and I'm like literally undressed on a massage table. And so I was like, can you please leave so I can get dressed? She doesn't leave and she continues to yell at me. So at this point I'm like, I really need you to leave. I'm extremely uncomfortable and I would really appreciate to speak to someone other than you once I'm like out of the room. She's like, well, my manager is not here today. And I was like, okay, I need you to leave. She finally leaves after asking her three times to leave. I am like freaked out. I feel incredibly vulnerable. I think any woman would feel incredibly vulnerable being undressed and having someone yell at you in a room where you're alone with them. All I knew is that I needed to get away from her. I go into the main lobby area. She's like, oh, how did you like your massage? I'm like, I didn't like my massage. I was in there for 15 minutes and like, I just can't even believe what just happened. And so I start explaining to this woman what just happened. And instead of her just like starting to like, I don't know, maybe like apologize, she instead is like, let me see if I can call my manager and make sure that you don't have to be charged for this. So I'm like, why would I be charged for this? I just got a 15-minute massage and got yelled at. She literally was just like giving me so much attitude when I was talking to the receptionist lady. I literally was talking to her like on the verge of tears because I was like in shock. And I cannot believe that this interaction happened with a bunch of women who know exactly why being undressed in a room alone, regardless of what the gender of the person is who's giving you that massage, that's very scary. I don't know what they're gonna do to resolve this, but I don't have very high hopes. And to be honest with you, I just don't even know that I ever wanna get a massage ever again.
50-50. 50-50.